Scowler and Ermius can paint a room in 8 hours if they work together. If Ermius were to work by himself, it would take him 5 hours longer than it would take Scowler working by himself. How long would it take Scowler to paint the room by himself if Ermius calls in sick? Round to 2 decimal places. To begin, it takes 8 hours to paint the room when working together. Let's record this below. The time it takes working together is 8 hours. And now let's determine the together rate, or the rate at which they paint the room when working together. If it takes them 8 hours to paint the room when working together, the together rate would be 1/8 of the room per hour. And now let's work on the time it takes Skylar and Ermius to complete the job when working alone. We don't know the exact time it takes, but we do know if Ermius were to work by himself, it takes him 5 hours longer than it takes Skylar working by himself. So we'll let the time it takes Skylar to complete the job alone be equal to T hours, which means that time it takes Ermius to complete the job alone would have to be the quantity T plus 5 hours. And now let's determine their rates per hour. Skylar's rate per hour would be 1 divided by T of the room per hour. For example, if it took Skylar 10 hours to complete the job alone, his hourly rate would be 1/10 of the room per hour. And then for Ermius's hourly rate, because it takes him T plus 5 hours to complete the job alone, the hourly rate would be 1 divided by the quantity T plus 5 of the room per hour. And now because they're working together, the sum of Skylar's and Ermius's rates must equal the together rate, which gives us the equation 1 divided by T plus 1 divided by the quantity T plus 5 must equal 1/8. And now we need to solve the rational equation. To do this, we'll clear the fractions from the equation by multiplying each fraction by the least common denominator. Notice in this case, the least common denominator is going to be the product of the denominators, which is 8 times t times t plus 5. So we'll now multiply each fraction by 8t times the quantity t plus 5. And now before determining each product, we will simplify. Notice for the first product, t divided by t simplifies to 1. For the second product, t plus 5 divided by t plus 5 simplifies to 1. And for the last product, 8 divided by 8 simplifies to 1. This leaves us with 8 times the quantity t plus 5 plus 8t equals t times the quantity t plus 5. And now we'll clear the parentheses and solve for t. Distributing 8, we have 8t plus 40 plus 8t equals on the right t squared plus 5t. Notice we have a quadratic equation, so we'll set the left side equal to 0. Before doing so, let's go ahead and simplify the left side though. 8t plus 8t is 16t, giving us 16t plus 40 equals t squared plus 5t. Now we'll subtract 16t on both sides and also subtract 40 on both sides, which gives us 0 equals t squared 5t minus 16t gives us minus 11t, and then subtracting 40 on both sides, we have minus 40. And now we need to solve this quadratic equation. Unfortunately, it's not factorable. There are no factors of negative 40 that add to negative 11, and therefore we'll have to use the quadratic formula, which I've included here on the right, where a is the coefficient of t squared, b is the coefficient of t, and c is the constant term, which indicates a equals 1, b equals negative 11, and c equals negative 40. Of course, instead of x, we have t. T is equal to, the numerator is negative b, or negative 11, plus or minus the square root of the quantity b squared minus 4ac, where b squared is the square of negative 11, minus 4ac is minus 4 times 1 times negative 40, all divided by 2 times a, which is 2 times 1. Simplifying, we have t equals positive 11 plus or minus the square root of The radicand is the square of negative 11, which is 121, minus 4 times 1 times negative 40, which gives us 121 plus 160, which equals 281. All divided by 2. Because the plus minus will have two solutions, we have t sub 1 equals and t sub 2 equals, and now we'll go to the calculator and round it to decimal places. So these should be actually approximation symbols, not equals, because we are going to round. So going to the calculator, t sub 1 is approximately 13.88, and t sub 2 is approximately negative 2.88. But of course, t is the number of hours it takes Skylar to complete the job, and t can't be negative. We can exclude t sub 2, leaving us with t equals 13.88 hours. So going back to the question, how long will it take Skylar to paint the room by himself if Hermes calls in sick? It takes Skylar t hours to paint the room by himself. We now know it'll take approximately 13.88 hours for Skylar to paint the room by himself. I hope you found this helpful.